Now we're going to take a look at a second example of using a slightly different method to solve rational equations or equations that contain fractions. The reason this method might be useful is normally when we see the addition or subtraction of fractions, the first thing we think of is that we have to have a common denominator. So for this method, we're first going to build each term so all the terms have the same least common denominator. Then we're going to multiply each term by the common denominator to clear the fractions from the equation, solve, and then check our solution or solutions. So looking at our example, notice how our denominators are 3, 4, 6, 2, and 12. The least common denominator is going to be the least common multiple of all of these numbers, which would also be the smallest number that's divisible by all of them, which means the least common denominator is going to be 12. 12 is the smallest number that's divisible by all of these values. So now we're going to rewrite each fraction so that it has a denominator of 12. So for our first fraction, 2/3 x, this is equivalent to 2x over 3. But because we want a denominator of 12, and 3 times 4 is equal to 12, we're going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by 4. Plus 3/4, and since 4 times 3 is equal to 12, we'll multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. Then we have minus 1/6 x, which is the same as 1x over 6, or just x over 6. So we have minus x over 6, and since 6 times 2 is equal to 12, we'll multiply the top and bottom by 2. Minus 1/2, again, since 2 times 6 is 12, we'll multiply the top and bottom by 6. And then finally on the right side, we have 7/12. Notice how the denominators are already 12. Now going back over to the first fraction, notice how we have 2 times 4 times x. That's going to be 8x over 12. Plus 3 times 3 is 9, so we have 9/12. Minus x times 2, that's 2x over 12. Minus, this would be 6 over 12. Equals 7/12. Now that all the fractions have the denominator of 12, we can clear the fractions by multiplying both sides of the equation by 12, or if we want, 12 over 1. Notice for each product, we'd have a factor of 12 over a factor of 12, which would simplify to 1, eliminating the fractions. So we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4 products. And our first product would just be 8x, because 12 over 12 simplifies to 1, so we have 8x. The second product would just be 9, so plus 9. The third product would be minus 2x. And the fourth product would just be minus 6. And on the right side, we just have 7. And now we're going to solve this equation to find our solution. So we'll start by combining like terms. 8x and negative 2x are like terms, and so are 9 and negative 6. 8x minus 2x is 6x, 9 minus 6 is 3, subtract 3 on both sides, so we have 6x equals 4, divide both sides by 6. So we have x equals 4, 6, but 4 and 6 do share a common factor of 2. So 4, 6 simplifies to 2/3. So our solution is x equals 2/3. Which means if we substitute 2/3 for x into the original equation, it should satisfy the equation. So let's go ahead and take a moment and do that. If x is 2/3, we'd have 2/3 times x, which is 2/3, plus 3/4, minus 1/6 times x, or 2/3, minus 1/2, equals 7/12. So this first product would be 4/9, plus 3/4, minus, here this does simplify, there's 1, 2, and 2, and 3 2's in 6, so we have minus 1/9, minus 1/2, equals 7/12. Well, 4/9 minus 1/9 would be 3/9. And 3/9 simplifies nicely to 1/3. So we'd have 1/3 plus 3/4 minus 1/2 equals 7/12. And now let's go ahead and obtain the common denominator of 12. So multiply this by 4/4, multiply this by 3/3, multiply this by 6/6. So we have 4/12 plus 9/12 minus 6/12 equals 7/12. And 4/12 plus 9/12 is 13/12 minus 6/12 is 7/12. So this verifies that our solution is correct. Our solution is x equals 2/3. I hope you found this helpful.